Hey guys, welcome to Wednesday Night Live. Sorry I am running late, but here we go. Let's do this thing.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go.
So I'm here with Mixed Media Guy, or Mr. Mixed Media Girl, which is his favorite. He's glaring at me. Alright, and we're going to be using, these are Pourage Posse paints. These are paints that Christina Welch makes and sells. So, hey guys, sorry I'm late. Veronica, can you get a link to Christina Welch's Etsy store for everybody else? And I will make sure that they go in the description later. I promise to protect. To at least try not to forget. So Johnny and I are going to actually mix these up and then we're going to get some painting done.
Yeah.
I haven't used these here yet at my own studio. I have used them at Christina's, but I think it'll be fun to get them all mixed up and use them here.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarah. Hey, Linda. Hey, Lee and Jeremy, or just Lee. Welcome, everybody. So I'm just using Floetrol. And let's go ahead. Can you grab some stir sticks right there? Just gonna put about a little less than a half a cup of Floetrol in each of these, and then we'll add our colors. And I think I'm gonna try, Johnny's gonna do his own color combination. But I'm going to do a color combination that I had a lot of fun with at Christina's, which was this moody blue that she has plus this lime green.
Ooh.
Yeah. And then like a pink add into that for a little pop.
I think you're short a cup, Ben. You got six there.
You're short.
Just throwing that out there.
Well, you can hand me another cup then. Hi, everybody. So I'm going to be using my usual paint mixing ratios of 2/3 Floetrol to 1/3 paint. Probably put a little too much Floetrol in these cups to make it really work very well. But here, you'll go ahead and do those guys. I'll do these guys.
Oh, purple, how'd you know?
I know, right? Oh, see, that's because I wasn't actually intending on mixing this one up. See, I did have a plan and you threw me off. That's okay.
Yes, dear.
All right. So this one is the Moody Blue Shimmer. Oh, is Christina here? Oh, hey, Christina. Just talking about you.
Purple pudding.
I'm finally using the Pourage Posse. Oh, there you go. Paints are 10% off on her Etsy right now.
Ooh, what?
For Christmas. You know what, guys? I'm going to adjust the camera a little bit just to get a little better angle. So you're just going to just take some with the stick.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And put it into the Floetrol.
Up to about like there, like just below the rim, man.
Yeah, like half the amount of the Floetrol.
Yeah. Yeah.
What do you mean just below the rim? Wait a second.
I mean, that's fine. Half the amount of Floetrol.
Got yeah, it. So like half of that. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a second. No. Going to slightly adjust. Everybody close your eyes. I take no responsibility for dizziness. There we go. That's better. And I can zoom in more later as needed once we start painting. It's a little hard to tell here. Live. Yeah. All right. Ooh. So this Moody Blue is like a gorgeous navy blue with a little bit of a shimmer to it. Super pretty. I don't know that we're going to want to mix up all these. That's so much. Do you want to use this color?
Yes.
Okay. And do you care about this one?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to put that off to the side. And then are you going to use both of these purples?
I mean, this one's pretty rad. I don't know that I need to. Okay. And they're fairly similar.
Yeah, so we'll put that one off to the side. Okay.
Christina, you done did purple right.
Yeah, right?
I approve.
Oh, yeah. We got our MacBook out. Oh, but I do need to mix. I'm going to mix some white. So that's just going to be Artist Loft white.
So we're doing this one as well, the purple raspberry.
This isn't even open. Do you want? Oh, yeah, I wanted that one.
Yeah. Raspberry beret.
Yeah, I love the navy and lime myself. So, all right, for the Artist Loft, I'm just using, or for the white, I'm just using the regular Artist Loft. So that's ready to be mixed. Now, normally I would pre-mix these. It's definitely better to mix these like the day before. But obviously that didn't happen. So we're going to make it work. Okay. All right. I am going to put a little more attention on these comments here. So if anyone has any questions, let me know. If anyone has any questions about the paint, Christina is here, so you can let her know. I very much enjoyed using these at her place, and the colors are just fantastic. So this is the lime. It's super bright and fun.
Yeah, I'm excited. Like a chartreuse, but more limey.
Okay. It's called Lemon Lime Shimmer. You didn't miss too much, Annabeth. We're just getting the rest of our colors mixed up here.
Just revving our engines.
Yeah, so I just have one more to mix, and you have one more to mix after that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. I need to mix this white a lot more.
Yeah.
Yeah, these are nice, nice, thick, pigmented paints.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't no Walmart craft paint.
Yeah, we ain't playing around.
Christina mixes her paints a little bit differently. Veronica, I think that's what you're asking, unless I missed an earlier question. She, I think, also uses some glue wall, and then she uses silicone generally in her paints. I'm just going to mix these my normal way. Annabeth, these are the Pourage Posse paints. These are the ones that Christina Welch makes and sells in her store. So I got like pretty much every color and we're using them here for the first time. I used them at Christina's studio, but I'm going to go ahead and use them with my mixing recipe. Whoa there. And no silicone. So I'm just adding a little water. This is just tap water. You know, I tried for a while, I used distilled water when mixing my paints, but I noticed literally zero difference. I think if you have a hard water situation or you have like water conditioner, then it would probably behoove you to use like a distilled water or something. But otherwise, my tap water works fine. Everybody's tap water is different though. Just saying.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay, this is exciting. I'm really excited about these colors.
I'm digging this blue. Blue's blowing my mind. Yep.
Aw, thanks, Massey Art Studio. Yes, Apple Barrel paint from Walmart works just fine as well. Don't knock it till you try it.
Should I be putting water in these?
Yeah, I'll dump a little in there for you.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I appreciate that.
So I just add a little bit of water at a time, then we'll mix it up and then we can add more as needed.
Righteous.
Key is to make sure it is well mixed. Now, I love mixing mine the day before because then that really, really makes sure that it's mixed.
Incorporated.
Yeah, but it's okay. We're gonna go for it.
It's Okay, we're doing good.
So we're going for a consistency of, like, there's always these food analogies. Warm honey, melted ice cream. Someone asked me to relate it to milk. I still think this is, like, the most hilarious question. Like, is it, like, non-fat milk or whole milk? I would be like, it's like half and half, or like heavy whipping cream, maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah. This white needs a little more water. So, guys, hit me up with any questions that you have. If you do have any. Yeah, distilled water is super cheap if you do want to do that. It's definitely...
It's like $1 a gallon or something.
Exactly, yeah.
And it goes last a long time.
Yeah. You're not using a lot. So to each his own. I'm just letting you guys know my thoughts on it.
A penny for your thoughts.
Yeah, I kind of hate mixing too.
Yeah.
It's like the least favorite. So many times I'm like, oh, I'm almost out of this color. And people are like, why are you always out of paint colors? I'm like, because I don't want to mix more. Seems kind of obvious.
Obby.
Stacy, my current favorite paint, well, it's hard because there's like metallics, there's neons. Generally speaking, I mostly use Artist Loft Flow acrylics for the basic colors. And then I love Arteza. Those are amazing. And then so far, I love these. I just haven't tried them out too much yet. So it'll be... Yeah. Interesting. I want to see the different reactions. Yeah. Hey now. Yeah, that cup was a little full.
Yeah.
The different reactions that we get and stuff. All right. And Johnny and I are each going to do our own canvases. We got people from all over the place. North Carolina, Nashville, Texas, Minnesota.
You got any Australia peeps in here tonight? I know they usually are.
Yeah, where are my Australia?
Where are the Aussies at?
Massachusetts. Yeah, very correct on the no hard and fast rule on paint mixing. A lot comes down to personal preference.
What about soft and slow?
I do need a gold in here. That's true.
Yeah, right?
Okay. Well, maybe... I was running so late. What about copper, Christina?
Copper goes good with blue.
Yeah, let's do copper. Okay, we'll do copper.
Did you save any copper?
This one's called Copper Penny. I was not intending to spend this much time mixing tape, but that's okay. All right, Johnny, talk about that fancy guitar in your next video, please.
Fancy guitar in my next video?
Yeah. Talk about your fancy guitar in your next video.
You lost me.
Went looking for gold, found copper. Oh! That's rude funny.
Awakening.
Okay.
Rude awakening.
It's okay. I got what you meant. That's hilarious. I am all for corny jokes.
Yes.
I am super corny.
Corny jokes for the win. I can mix it up if you like. I know you don't like mixing.
Yeah.
And I'm a good husband, so I'm going to help you.
That's why I got married.
Yep.
So I did some mix my paint.
Pretty much.
Okie dokie dokie. All right. So you're going to use those guys.
Yeah.
You're not using this one, right?
I am.
Oh, you are.
Yeah.
Well, I asked and you were like, no.
You didn't. That wasn't on that one. That was on the red over there.
Whatever. Okay. Awesome. All right.
And I may steal a dash of this copper.
No.
Yeah.
Okay. So I also have something exciting. Now, I wish I had more than one because I don't want to use them all. But, I have a brand new split cup, you guys. This is the triple split cup. Super exciting. So I'm actually going to go ahead and use that. It does have some wet paint in it because I already did a painting earlier.
Three splits, four slots.
I'm just going to go ahead and go with it. Like, I'll put navy blue in here. I'll put the lime. I'll put the pink and the white. Perfect.
Navy blue.
That'll work actually perfectly. Blue. Well, it's a triple split cup because it has three splits, but it has four, or I guess it's three slits.
Triple slit, four slots.
Yeah, four slots. I know. So brand spanking new. Here's the other two, just in case. So we have the double split and the single split. And now the triple split.
Oh my God, the granddaddy of split cups.
I know. So anyways, that just went up in my store like 10 seconds ago, you guys.
You should come up with a 20 split.
No, that seems highly impractical. Yeah. All right. So actually, Veronica, if you feel like grabbing the link to that, that would be great. I'm going to go ahead and start with mine. So in this side, I'm going to put navy blue. Where am I going to put the copper? I guess maybe on top of that? No. Maybe in the white?
Yeah.
In the white. Okay. I'm going to put the lime in here. Put the lime and the coconut.
And drink it all up.
And yeah.
Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right.
Here I am. Stuck in the middle.
There's only two of us. There is no middle.
Well, maybe the computer is another person.
Well, then I guess you are stuck in the middle. Congratulations.
Exactly.
You get to be right this time.
You're not done with that yet?
I have a touch more water. You're welcome. Which cup am I using?
Do have a set, you guys, of all three 10 ounces. So I made a whole separate listing for that on Etsy, by the way.
Ooh,
So on this side, I'm going to put the white and the copper.
Which cup am I using? Triple split.
Well, I was going to ask you that. Remember, you were like, we can take turns with the...
Well, we can, totally.
Or do you want to use the other one?
I mean, it's the Marcy show, so
right, whatever you want. Right, but it's, you know, your painting. I'm going to put some white in the middle here.
That's a good idea. I like that idea.
So, either hang out and wait for this one. All right. I put the white in the middle, but then I was like, maybe I'll do a traveling tree ring. I don't know, maybe I'll just do a regular one. Ooh.
Oh, that's pretty wild.
Yeah.
And crazy.
Okay. Plans change. Regular tree ring it is.
I'm doing three little tree rings.
Yeah, you are.
That's going to be fun. I feel like I'm making pancakes.
Wow.
Yeah, give me the triple split cup because I'm just realizing there's going to be a lot of bleed over from your colors in there.
Yeah, okay.
That could just end up being going in directions I don't intend it to. Nobody likes that.
So Massey Art Studio asked if I'm planning on doing this triple split in the 6 ounce cup. I think I should. So I now have one request. Do I have two? I am coming out also later this week with a quadruple split.
Ooh, doggy.
Right. So it'll have 5 slots. I have to redesign. Okay, you'll be first in line for the 16 ounce cup. Okay. I will have it right out to you. All right, I'm gonna wait till he's done before I start tilting because we're kind of in close quarters here.
Yeah, it's a little tight.
And so for these cups, you can either just go ahead and rinse them out right away, or like I do, you can just put it upside down and drain the excess paint out and let it dry. So.
Okay, here we go. It's gonna be wild and crazy.
Okay, I'm gonna move these cups out of the way before we knock them over. By we, I mean you.
Whatever.
All right. And Johnny's just doing his own thing. I have no control over him, so don't even. I think I want to put a little navy around my edges to make sure I have plenty of paint here. Plus, I really like this moody blue. Navy blue has lately become like my favorite color. I already loved blue and now it's navy blue. I've been using navy blue instead of black, so that's making a lot of people happy. All the anti-black people. I love black. I love all the colors though.
Yeah.
And I am not a lime green fan, but using this at Christina's with the navy blue was...
That's working.
Yeah. I was like, oh my goodness.
I got a square tree ring. How the hell did that happen?
You must have watched my square tree ring video yesterday.
Yes.
No, just kidding. In my sleep. That happens when you do a tree ring in between other things. In between other tree rings.
Oh, because it pushes the paint, yeah, and then the paint squares it off. I see. That's kind of cool.
It is.
I like it. I'm not sure where this is going to go, but we'll see.
Okay. This is so exciting.
Zippering this so it doesn't fly all over the place.
Oh, love it. Okay.
Yeah.
Are you able to tilt yours without getting it on mine?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I have some faith.
Oh, get out of here. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah, this is definitely a lime green. It does look yellow on the screen. I get that. It's like a lime yellow, I guess. So it does lean towards yellow a little bit. Thank you, Becky. But yeah, when I bring it in for the close-up, you guys will hopefully see the colors a little bit better. Ooh. Party on Johnny's canvas.
Oh, yeah. Run this away. Run!
Who else is having a heart attack about his hand close to my painting?
Oh, you're fine.
I'm sure I am. That doesn't mean I'm not having a heart attack.
Your whatever.
Xena Designs, I'm going to send you a message, okay? On Instagram. I'm like horrible on Instagram, but I know you're on Instagram all the time, so. Okay. Are you able to scooch it a little bit this way? So it's on the parchment paper?
Yeah.
Okay, that's not helping. Don't, never mind. Just kidding. Never mind. Okay. It's okay.
But I didn't mess your painting.
Just kidding.
You're welcome.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and wipe my hands off and then bring you guys in for a close-up. Oh, I have a corner over here I didn't get.
Oh, no.
Okay. All right, so camera is going to shake.
Rattle and roll.
No, it's not going to rattle or roll. It's just going to shake a little bit. So close your eyes for a second. Yeah. No, you're fine. I mean, you can if you want.
I did. It was kind of fun. Kind of glad you suggested it.
Okay, let's start with Johnny's. Super fun. Of course, he went with purple. And that purple and the Sleeping Beauty turquoise shimmer.
Yes.
That's that turquoise is so pretty.
It is super pretty.
Beautimous.
I don't know what I made, but I like it.
Awesome. Okay, and then here's mine. Hopefully it looks a little more lime green close up, but it does lean towards yellow, but it is definitely lime. I am so happy with this. I'm having fun kind of getting out of my color comfort zone sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
Super pretty. Yeah, it will dry greener. Okay, cool, Christina. I mean, either way, I'm super happy with it. I think it's gorgeous.
Nice right. Cell action, too.
Oh, yeah.
Really cool.
I'm going to put the phone back because I'm very shaky right now. Okay. And then I know this isn't like the longest live video, you guys, but I think that's all we're going to do for tonight. I can give you guys a few sneak peeks, though. So the video coming out tomorrow is some fall leaf resin coasters. So I'm just letting these dry a little bit more before peeling them out of the molds. And this isn't in the same video, but I made it at the same time. Some really pretty flower coasters. And then, oh my gosh, I would show you some other things, but my studio's a hot mess.
Yeah, lukewarm mess.
No, it's a hot mess because it's being redone. Let's blame it on that because it was so clean before that.
Yeah, totally. It was immaculate. Man.
Anyways, I was filming all day my 50 techniques, 50 acrylic pour techniques course, which launches next week. So if you guys have not signed up yet, make sure you get signed up. Special sale price going on right now. I think the link is in the description, but if not, Veronica, could you grab it real quick? What would I
Wait,
do
where?
without her? Oh
Yeah,
my
right?
goodness. And
Our pet giraffe.
yeah, I think that's it. As always, thank you guys so much
Johnny
for
has a channel.
joining us. Make sure you're subscribed to Johnny's channel. Well, can you get the link real quick and post it in the chat box?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, make sure you're subscribed to Johnny's channel. And don't forget to like. Okay, Pina's asking how to reuse canvases. Here, hand me one of those in the 8x10s. There's a little,
Yeah, I
yeah,
see.
that one. Okay. Generally speaking, what I do is if there's something, if I don't like one, I just go ahead and paint right over it. This is I primed it. Now, if you have silicone, you're gonna need to clean that off. So if you have silicone, you can literally put your painting in the sink with some soap and some dish soap and water and wash it. Let it dry and then just go ahead and prime and use it. If you didn't use silicone and you don't have anything weird with it, you can generally just go ahead and prime and paint right over. Or actually, most of the time, you probably don't even have to prime. You can just paint right over without doing anything. I've done that many times.
And that one, I believe, is spray paint prime, like just a white spray paint, but you can also use like just the cheap, it's less than $20 a gallon, just
Yeah,
regular
this is
exterior paint.
paint and primer,
Yeah.
spray paint. So, anyways, sorry, Brian, I gots to go. But thank you guys so much for joining me. Check out Johnny's channel. Check out the Pourage Posse paints. Check out the new cup. Make sure you're signed up for the course coming out next week. And I love you all. See you next time.
Mwah.